The economy was in meltdown mode. Unemployment lines were growing and Americans were losing their homes at a record rate.
I'm trying to keep it together. You know, it's hard.
Congress quickly signed off on a new stimulus bill.
The bill is passed,
which the new president signed into law.
We have begun the essential work of keeping the American dream alive in our time.
Despite the government's best efforts, two of the big three filed for bankruptcy.
The GM that many of you knew is history.
And Chrysler was pressured into an alliance with Italy's Fiat. Americans rushed to trade in their clunkers for cash.
I got $4,500 for this car.
And threw a lifeline to the auto industry. Home prices nosedived and a tax credit brought out first-time home buyers. Bernie Madoff got a new home, sentenced to 150 years in prison for wiping out clients in a $60 billion fraud.
Nothing left. I'm on food stamps.
Even in tough times, people paid up for a piece of Madoff. His Long Island Beach home sold for $9 million, and his personal effects brought in more than $1 million at auction. Then, on September 15th, the Federal Reserve declared the recession was behind us.
From a technical perspective, the recession is very likely over.
But tell that to the 16 million out-of-work Americans. The unemployment rate topped 10% to a 26-year high.
How am I going to support my family without an income that I can depend on?
And to the dismay of retailers, consumers remain tight-fisted. But the stock market flexed its muscle and clawed its way back from a bear market. The Dow rallied about 20% for the year, the NASDAQ a whopping 40%.
Traders feel confident that, you know what, we're over the worst.
Wall Street bonuses also made a comeback as banks rushed to repay taxpayers the bailout money. And fine jewelry was suddenly worth a lot more as gold prices cracked $1,200 an ounce. The recession may be over, but the Fed chief says it's still too early to say if the recovery will last. Alexis Christophorus, CBS News, New York.